Hi, I'm Nick from Australian Native Bee. Today I'm going to talk to you about four different types of swarms that you can get with your native bees.
Oh, you would say that oh, I could run, but
the first swarm I'm going to talk about is the drone swarm. Drone swarms are probably the most common swarm you will see. They can be seen as gentle wafting swarms with bees resting on the boxes and branches nearby the hive. Drone swarms start out seemingly small but can end up with a couple of hundred bees in them. To tell if you have a drone swarm, have a look around on the tree branches surrounding your hive. You should find drones resting on the branches at night time. Drones have a particular stance that they like to take, tails pointed down and antennas pointed up in sort of a bunny ear looking fashion. The next swarm we're going to look at is the colonizing swarm. Colonizing swarms can be seen moving up and down the sides of houses, fences and other objects, looking for a new place to live. It is not uncommon to see a colonizing swarm stay in one area for over a month. Like drone swarms, they may contain only a few hundred bees, but then grow to a very large swarm. Here is an example of that. You can see the bees moving up and down all around, all over the tree, looking for something to colonize. Once a colonizing swarm has discovered something it wants to colonize, all the bees will face the same direction towards the object. At this point, the haphazard flying in all different directions stops, all the bees face one way, and the swarm becomes a very tight swarm. Colonizing swarms are good because that means the area is a healthy area for bees. Colonizing swarms can also pose some problems. They can be the triggers to both fighting swarms and defensive swarms with existing hives in the area. This brings us to the next type of swarm, the fighting swarm. Fighting swarms are the most vicious swarms and can often contain thousands and thousands of bees. Telltale signs of a fighting swarm are a vortex swarm pattern with bees dropping out of the swarm, locked together. This is a good indicator you have a fighting swarm. Bees from different hives will lock together and hang on till the very end. Fighting swarms can be very costly to your bee numbers and often end with your hive being completely taken over by another hive of bees. Like all things, there is a positive. You can try your hand at swarm capture and end up with another hive of bees. The last swarm we're going to look at is the defensive swarm. These happen when a hive feels threatened by another hive of bees. Defensive swarms can be seen hanging about a meter off the front of the hive that sent out the defensive swarm. They are a gentle swarm in that you do not end up with a bunch of dead bees on the ground following the swarm. I hope this video helps you to identify the type of swarm that you have.